Okay then, so hello guys and welcome to our R&D.
Do remember to let us know which areas of the car you'd like us to develop using the laptop. I'll leave that.
I did tell you what you wanted us to develop in the last episode. I definitely did this, didn't I? Please tell me they're on the car. Please. Please, Williams are upgraded. No, we did all of that R&D for this race specifically. I'm so sure I did it at the end of the last... I'm gonna have to go back and find that, because I definitely put it on, so... Well, we're now going into the British Grand Prix on the back foot, as it turns out, so... Yeah. Quite looking forward to seeing the local heroes smash their record, lovely. Loving that. So we've got 1,341 points, plus the R&D we get today, so I guess for the next race, which I think... is Germany, maybe? It's either Germany or Hungary. So either one, we're then going to go into it with loads of upgrades. But I want to go into this race with loads of upgrades. So let's just go to practice then, I guess, and see how practice goes. And we need to get this R&D pretty sorted for practice, I think. Because else we are actually going to go in... to the next race on the back foot, so we do need to make sure that we do actually get this properly correct here. Let me fuck this up.
Welcome to Silverstone, home of Formula One racing in Great Britain, where shortly we're expecting the cars to appear for today's practice session.
We are, so look at this for our track acclimatization. Absolutely incredible. Look, are we going to completely do this purple? We are. This is going to be our first purple one. So nearly missed it. Wow, completely clean, absolutely gorgeous. I'm loving it, absolutely loving it. And then race pace, not race pace, qualifying pace. We weren't as quick as we could have been. We were traction at the end of corners. We were really struggling with this, so we just gave up on this lap and just cut it to see if we gain any time. But no, we just couldn't do it. We couldn't get it. So we got perfect track acclimatization, qualifying pace. We got another 30 points. So it did pretty well, disability records. Not one penalty. Didn't even know we got a penalty. Had another 139, so that brings us up to 1480, which is pretty nice. I'm loving that. So that was our practice, to be honest. We didn't actually need to do any more practice as we tried the tire acclimatization, not tire, tire management, that's one. That's one thing, obviously tire management, and it just wasn't happening. So let's listen to this voicemail from Emma then, shall we? If we are actually going to click on it. Oh my god. Here we go.
Qualifying goals for this weekend.
Lovely, 8th or higher, beat arrival Max Verstappen and then beat Jensen Button. Pretty standard. Have you just noticed outside? It is pouring it down with rain. Oh Jesus, that's not great. So yes, full wet tyres, absolutely unbelievable. So this was our first lap, as you can see, lap 1. Not a bad lap, a little bit scruffy, we just got far too much oversteer at some points in the trail, but not too bad. We were 1.4 off the pace. But after this lap, we decided, well, let's keep going. Let's sort of keep moving the water and see how that goes. And lap 2, we were 7/10 above it. We got great exit, got 8/10, so we're now 6/10 off the pace. So that was lap 2. And then lap 3, as we can see now, was going absolutely incredibly. And we actually got pole position with that lap. It was an incredible lap. I don't know why I don't have the footage for it. I think my Elgato was having an absolute pissy day. But yeah, look at that. Absolutely incredible there. Pole position by 4/10 over Lewis Hamilton, Nico Rosberg by 5/10. And where was our teammate? I think our teammate was P13, about a second and a half back. So absolutely amazing qualifying session. Really on the nail. And then pole position... whatever it is, you know what I mean. Accomplishment, achievement, that's it. So that's the first pole position on this game. Another 88 resource points as well. And how are we going to do against Max Verstappen? Perfectly by the looks of it. Yep, perfectly. Absolutely gorgeous. So we beat that rivalry. So I don't know how we're doing on rivalries won and lost. I think we've won both of ours. So yep, we are so far ahead of our second driver. Absolutely beautiful. Wouldn't surprise me if we got first driver, so let's listen to our race voicemail from Emma.
Hi, it's Emma here. Just wanted to let you know what the team are hoping for in the race.
Team are hoping for 5th place or higher, beat Jensen Button, place 10 or higher, so I guess from pole position 5th is actually a pretty likely thing, but I guess we'll have to see about that one. So, yeah, I think let's go to the race. And I'm just going to let Crofty and Anthony Davidson take it away for the race. And enjoy.
We're right back where it all began. The very first World Championship Grand Prix was held here at Silverstone in 1950, with Giuseppe Farina taking the top step of an all-Alfa Romeo podium. He earned 9 championship points that day on his way to the inaugural title. His winning total at the season's end, just 30 points. My, how times have changed. So let's see who can reach the top step of the modern podium today. Straddling the border of Northamptonshire and Buckinghamshire, the 18 corners of the Silverstone circuit form the 3.6-mile beating heart of Formula One. It's been reinvented over the years, with Turn 1 now the fast right-hander of Abbey, along with 2 DRS zones on the Wellington and Hanger Straits respectively. But the magic of racing is as strong here as it's ever been. With me today is a man who's no stranger to the thrills of Silverstone. He's a past winner here, in sports cars, of course. It's our good friend, Anthony Davidson. You seem particularly excited for this one, Ant. Is there something you want to tell me?
Oh, just looking forward to it, Crofty. It's always a very special atmosphere. And also, I started karting in the late 1980s, and I was here for that epic race in 1986 with Manson and Piquet fighting each other right here in my home Grand Prix. So coming back to Silverstone always means a lot. And looking at the crowd today, it's clear that none of that spirit has been lost. And also, we just have such a fantastic field this year. Some very close competition and conditions that should make for some great racing. I can't wait.
Okay, I know it's your home Grand Prix, but treat it like any other race. Don't take unnecessary risks.
With that then, let's run through the grid order. It's McLaren in pole position then. And Lewis Hamilton completes the front row. Looking down the rest of the grid, we...
Okay then, yeah, so guys, welcome to the race. Race strategy is fairly standard of a soft and medium setup. However, do we change that to a medium and soft setup and hold everyone up behind us and then we have pace at the end? Ooh, hold on. Now, hold on, we're going to have to go there and then medium. That will change it by 0.25 of a second. If I did it like that. Oh, let's just go like that. I like that idea. That looks pretty cool. So, fuel, it's only 13 laps. We always end up with far too much fuel. So let's put in 14 laps worth of fuel. And do the formation lap, and I'll join you at the end of the formation lap. Okay then, so guys, we are waiting for the lights, maintain optimal RPM, we are waiting for the lights, and we are off! Really, really shocking start, although mind you, Hamilton's got absolute blinder, Rosberg's not making up any distance on me. Hamilton's cut the corner slightly, we're going to make it around the outside here, maybe not. Oh my god, it's right about now, I wish I'd have had those upgrades on my car, because we could have been so much faster. However, in practice, I think we were third on our qualifying pace. So we weren't too bad, so we'll try and hold these guys up behind, we'll go long into the race, and then we'll have the soft tyre to really attack the cars in front. It won't be like Austria, where we actually did have some genuinely quick pace, but I think we'll still be okay. Oh god, that's not good that my controller batteries are low. Oh my god, this might actually just stop working halfway through. Oh Jesus. Let's hope they last for 25 minutes. God, Rosberg's got a worldie of a run. And we've collided. Rosberg's off. Wow. Did I cut him off a little bit too much then? I might be able to get a replay, but I don't actually know if we're going to cut it at the end. So I did want to get through this section. So, let's have a look. Can we see exactly what happened? No. We can only see Rosberg being very sideways. So where's Rosberg come out here? So we'll look, Rosberg's going to come out completely last here. Wow. Okay, we might have to get a little bit of a replay at the end of that one. But actually no, I think I might leave it. Let's leave my dignity intact for this one, I think. Have a look at that. Max Verstappen is up into the podium positions. But it's a British 1-2 here for the British Grand Prix, which would be amazing. If I can get stick on the podium, I don't think we'll win. But if we can stick on the podium, it would be incredible. Jesus, Hamilton's caught up to us so quickly. We had a vague purple middle sector. But Hamilton has just got so much pace. The soft tyre to the medium tyre is really showing here now. Just by the amount of, you know, the traction that he can get between the two different tyres. But if we can hold him up, then he is not getting away from us. So, might need to start putting up into... shut up, engineer. Oh my god, Vettel's actually going fast. Hamilton's around the outside as he got much better traction, but we're going to hold it around the outside. Beautifully done. Hamilton will have DRS here. We're going to get out of his slipstream. But he's not going to get past us. So we'll just hold it around the inside, which will then turn to the outside and then to the inside, and we are absolutely fine. This is a battle, I think. We're just going to have to keep holding him off. Hamilton's coming around the outside. I actually can't remember. Is that a Stowe? I can't remember. My corner names are poor, but where's Hamilton gone? I'll probably have to flash that back, because I tell you what, I am not going through there. That would just be a stupid idea. So we do block him off here. We don't... And Hamilton's just gone really wide, and he's ended up behind Sebastian Vettel. Which is a little bit... annoying, because I was enjoying battling him, but we'll flash back from there, because I'm just going to crash going through this corner. It would just be ridiculous. And now Verstappen is behind us as we go wide. Jesus Christ, where are we going? Now we could have to stay in Verstappen's slipstream, but our engine power is of course not great. Verstappen's actually getting away with DRS and everything. We are going to be swallowed up here. We might lose Hamilton's round our outside. We've got Vettel there. Oh my god, we might actually make this work. No, so close to making it work though. We're going to go up the inside of Max Verstappen here though. And we do make the move, stick back up into first place. We managed to salvage that to have Hamilton and Vettel round the outside of us. And Verstappen's gone wide as well as we make that diving move. And Vettel's now up into second place. So everything's going on here. There's a couple now in the pits as well. We are losing our concentration so much right now, as you can see. We need to just gain our Oh my god, I actually can't think of the word now. Jesus Christ. Whatever word I just said, we need to gain it back. And we just need to keep battling and just try and stay ahead of these guys, because else when they get ahead, they are going to be ultimately so fast. A Vettel swoops down the outside. We're going to try and hold it round the outside here. Vettel's pushed us wide though. Vettel has pushed us so wide. We're going to dive it at the inside, but no, Vettel is now, you would think, going to get away from us. Because we were going to hold it around the outside, and he's made a move to the right, which I think is a little bit unfair. Not too happy with that, but I guess we'll have to make it stick. Hamilton's now behind us. Vettel we're going to try and catch up on. I'm getting now no force feedback from my controller because it's turned off. Well, not turned off, but it's so low on battery. I might have to just plug it in a second. Alright, DRS on Sebastian Vettel here. Just a little bit further on into the race. Hamilton's going to come past though, so we are going to try and make the move round the inside, down the inside. I think Vettel's going to pit here. No, is Hamilton going to pit? Is anyone going to pit? No, so they're going to stay out for another lap here. And those soft tyres must be graining a little bit. What's our tyre wear? Not bad. Our tyre wear is pretty good, actually. I won't let it go above 60, but my god, the traction Hamilton's got from there is absolutely unbelievable. We're going to go round the outside again, and we've made that move stick. Traction, traction, traction. Hamilton, we've got better traction than Hamilton. Vettel is getting away though. But Hamilton, look at that straight line speed just through there. Gonna go around the outside, that's fine. Run a little bit wide, but it's okay. Hamilton will stay behind us. Vettel, although seem to have loads of paces, he's still in our sights. You know, he's not massively far away from us here. As we do go so wide, Hamilton's definitely gonna get us here, but I think he's gonna dive into the bits. How much fuel have we got left in the car? We've got so much fuel left to burn. So I think we'll burn it. Oh my god, we're going to get absolutely screwed here by Daniel Ricciardo as well. It's around the outside. We're going to make it around the outside of Lewis Hamilton here. We do run wide, but no, it's not going to happen. Hamilton's going to dive into the pits. So is Daniel Ricciardo. Now here's where the pit stop phase happens. We are now going to slide it up into Rich Mix, I think. teammates in the pits. Button was actually in that small train here. So now we are going to put it up into Rich, as Verstappen's going to come round the outside here. We make it. We hold that line beautifully. Hold that line, may I just say? So we will probably leave this as I sort of concentrate. That's the word I was thinking of. I don't concentrate. Verstappen might have us here, but unlikely. But we are going to just concentrate, not say anything, and I'll probably join you when we are about to come into the pits. As Verstappen, is he going to make a move? No, it's far too far back. So, yes. Oh my god, we've actually run so well. But yeah, I'm just going to not talk, concentrate, because we need this. This is the important phase of the race now. And just talk to you when we get to the pit stop phase, because that's going to be when the crucial part ends and when we just need to see where we come as Verstappen is making a move. Alright, so yes, we are into the pits now. Braking actually unbelievably late there. So Hamilton was 22 seconds behind on the last sector time that we saw. He was gaining, obviously, because he's on a much, much newer set of mediums. But he did hit traffic. There we go, 22.3 he was. So I literally have no idea where he's going to come out in comparison to us. There's a yellow flag as well, look. So I don't know what that's for. Don't know whether, by the looks of it, is there going to be a safety car for that? I want to see what that is. Hold on. Let's just have a look down the order. There's some battling going on here. And, oh, wow. Hold on. There was a Ferrari battling. That must be Max Verstappen, maybe? And Raikkonen. Oh, no, Max Verstappen's just gone wide, look. Why are you changing to a different camera? And he's just gone. So, maybe not a safety car, because he isn't actually retired. He will keep going. But look at this. How close is this going to be? We are going to come out probably behind Lewis Hamilton. That's okay. That's not bad. Are we going to come out behind Sebastian Vettel as well? There we are. We are. So, we've lost a place to Hamilton, lost a place to Vettel, which is sort of not surprising, really. Why would you put me out onto the grass? Look. What? Okay then, so starting lap 13, we are slowly but surely catching up Sebastian Vettel, but it's the slowly part. Vettel's just got way, way, way too much pace. He is actually genuinely very quick currently, however we have caught up to him very, very, a lot on this sector, it looks like it. Yep, oh my god, no one cares. My god, there's another yellow flag. There's a few yellow flags going on here. But yeah, it's the slowly part I'm not enjoying here of catching Sebastian Vettel here. So we are going quick, but Vettel's just outright pace is pretty solid here. Hamilton's getting away as well, slowly but surely, about 5 seconds ahead of Vettel. So I guess we'll just hold out for a podium here. So this bit probably won't be too exciting, because it will just be me racing, vaguely catching Vettel, but not much. So a podium is still pretty damn good though. We were good on the qualifying because we were sort of, you know, I think we're the third fastest car out of all the cars. So behind obviously the Mercedes and the Ferrari. So I think we got it by the fact that we've got an amazing chassis and we are perfectly suited for the wet. So that's probably why we got pole, and you know, I'm just more confident in the wet than some of the AI and things like that. So yeah, so I'm happy with the podium. That's probably how it will stay. I don't think we'll get Vettel, so I'll probably see you at the end of the race. Oh my god, look, there's a yellow flag ahead. And it is. Who is it? We might take the lead here. Gutierrez is the one that slowed down, and we are going to take everyone here. A legal overtake. Who are we going to... legal overtake on Hamilton. Hamilton's going to have to go past. Vettel, however, won't go past. We are much closer to Lewis here. With the final lap to go. Us on the softs, him on the mediums. We could genuinely steal the win here. Still the yellow flag behind us for the incident, but look how close we are now to Hamilton. We've overtaken Sebastian Vettel, so I think we're going to stay on board here. I apologise if I don't talk much, because this is going to be an exciting end to the race here. Vettel's close. Hamilton's now getting away. Hamilton's pace this weekend has just been pretty unreal as we do get on the grass. Now, centre's wide. That second, that is. I don't think we're going to get Hamilton now. We needed a perfect lap, and we're not going to get it here. We'll get DRS. Vettel's now unbelievably close as well. We are up into Richmond. Vettel will get out of Vettel's slipstream, look, as he does come flying past. And there we go, through there nicely. But yeah, Hamilton's pace has been unreal. Vettel got so far ahead of me, and Hamilton was stuck behind me. And he's done unbelievably well, not only to overtake Vettel while they're on the same strategy, but also to get about 5-6 seconds ahead. It was unreal. So I think we're just going to have to hold it out here for the second place. It was just a fight for, not a fight for the podium as such, but just a fight for who finishes where. Hamilton already got away. Look at that. That's unbelievable. We have broken them so early there. Vettel's going to have an unbelievable chance. How good's our traction out of this corner? Not great. Not great at all. Vettel's going to get DRS. Vettel's going to come flying by here. So we are going to tuck into his slipstream. Hamilton's already 3 seconds ahead. Whoa! Traction. Vettel's gone wide. Get out of the way, Vettel. And there is Massa. Oh my God, there's Felipe Massa. We're going to block him. I didn't realise Massa was just there. He obviously didn't get held up by Gutierrez. So Vettel's not even on the podium, because he just randomly slowed down. But oh my God, what a finish to the race. Absolutely unbelievable. I did think I got first then when I overtook Hamilton, but it wasn't to be. Hamilton there, absolutely amazing. Us on the podium with Massa in second. Basically an all-white podium look. Just look at the overalls of the drivers, was unreal. There we go, lifting another second place. Ah, oh, I'm loving lifting these trophies. And there we go, absolutely amazing, a win there, and a decent quick lap as well. We were the third fastest on track, really. Rosberg actually got a slower, fastest time than us by a hundredth of a second. But yeah, look, Hamilton and Vettel doing faster lap times, but we're the ones that come home in second. So, looking down the order, Raikkonen had to do a two-stop, obviously an incident in the first lap. Rosberg did well to come back into 11th, but still not great. Verstappen obviously had that incident with, I think it might have been Kimi Raikkonen. Gutierrez was a lap down. Magnussen didn't finish. What does that do for the drivers? Drivers, we are up into 4th place in the drivers. Oh my God, 86 points off of Nico Rosberg. So we gained a little bit on him, but wow, look at that. Up into 4th place. I think I might have to change the difficulty on this slightly, but we've got 71 points in Jensen. We've got about 91 points more than Jensen for the constructors. That still leaves us in 4th place. So, as we go back, there is some massive drilling going on outside. It is so wet also as well. So there is the R&D we get for the race. Positions lost 1, but pretty sure we can take that. So now I've got 1,682 points to spend. Even though they should have already been spent, they weren't. So let's continue. 21 laps. Do. There, yeah, there's my career score if anyone cares. Contract, oh my God. Contract.
And we all agree, the only thing better than a number 2 driver is a number 1 driver. Here are the details.
Sweet. Thank you very much, Emma. Jensen's now not looking so pleased. Senior management, under your recent performance, have decided to promote you to the team's first driver. You will receive an additional bonus after each race to reflect your additional responsibilities. We look forward to seeing where you take the team in the upcoming months. Thank you very much, McLaren Honda. So we are now first driver here, and we get additional R&D points. Unbelievable. There we go. So, we've defeated our rival Max Verstappen, obviously. So, where are we going to spend these points? Do we spend a little bit on down? I think an engine upgrade is the way to go. I think it just is. I think we do need to spend it. So we got a huge upgrade going on there. And then 582, we'll put on some downforce. There we go. Loving that. So, I think the next thing will be aerodynamic drag. Hold on, what are the next races to come up? Trophy room, we got Hungary, nice and downforce. Germany, nice and downforce. Belgium, a little bit of both. So we are going to need the engine for that one. Italy and Monza, we are going to need to sort of take the drag down a bit. So for before Italy, we need to add a drag, chassis weight, fuel efficiency. So what we'll do is we'll go to next weekend and make sure that that actually does do it. Close the settings for that. I do just want to make sure that it... Oh, nice screen. I haven't actually seen that before. I do actually want to make sure that they go on for this weekend. So we'll probably see our engineer come in. Once it finally loads. Oh my god, come on. I didn't actually realise the loading times for this game were... Oh no, they're okay. Come on then. Let's show us the money then. Yes, it looks green. It looks green. It looks green. You can see it green and it looks like it's going to actually do something. Alright, here we go then. Here we go then. There we go.
Okay, I've got something for you. The new parts have been fitted for the car. The simulation numbers are good, so look forward to your feedback. Check out the details.
I will check out the details. Thank you very much, Rob. I think that's his name anyway. Engine upgrade 3 of 5. We get another 8 brake horsepower. Redesign, so whatever. That literally means nothing to me. We also have... downforce. We have got another 1.8% of downforce, so that looks lovely, moving airflow around. So who else has bought upgrades? We have upgrades. Toro Rosso have bought two lots of upgrades, and that's going to put us about here. We've been overtaken by Toro Rosso. No, we might not have been, actually. I don't know. Yeah, that's pretty interesting. We've got quite a way ahead now of Force India, who are pretty close. Haas haven't made much improvement recently. Sauber, I don't think, have bought a single upgrade by the looks of them. Mercedes are pretty close to the end of their R&D that they can do, so that's pretty interesting. So thank you guys so much for watching. Been a great episode. Loved it so much. So yeah, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you guys next time.